Our next speaker is Dr. Zuhair Nasser Alhassnan. He's a consultant in genetics. He's going to speak about the inherited metabolic disorder screening.
Assalamu alaikum. Good afternoon. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I would like first to thank the organizers for their kind invitation. Special thanks to Dr. Abdul Hakim Qattan. My title of the presentation is Inherited Metabolic Diseases Screening. And I think everyone in this room would agree that there are certain metabolic conditions in which screening early on and early detection and treatment would have a great impact, and this has to be implemented universally across our population. And I will start with this tale of the three Saudi girls with phenylketonuria who are followed up in my clinic. You know, the first one is a 12-year-old girl who is affected with phenylketonuria, and she has a normal development. She's always first in her class, brilliant child. The second girl is a 15-year-old girl affected with the same disease, but she has severe intellectual disability. And the third one is a 4-year-old, and again she has severe intellectual disability. The first child was born in the States. She got the screening early, very compliant family, treatment has been very well over the years, and that's why you have this outstanding outcome. And that's what we want to have across all children with phenylketonuria. The second child I saw for the first time when she was a 3-year-old as a case of intellectual disability and hyperactivity. She was referred to an outreach clinic in Hail, and I saw her then, and her phenylalanine was very high. And that was before launching the newborn screening for metabolic diseases across the country. But unfortunately, I saw this girl a couple of years ago who was born in Riyadh, in the capital city of this country, and it was missed. And she was born in one of the large hospitals, the private hospitals in the country. And basically this slide, I think, summarizes the significance of screening for metabolic diseases and the problems that we have in this country. So we'll go over the history, some points. The history starts with screening for congenital hypothyroidism with an effort from the group in the university, King Khalid University Hospital, led by Professor Al-Jarayan, Abdurrahman Naim, Al-Hurbish. And it was a cord blood screening. The project was a pilot, started in 1988, and the incidence was estimated then to be 1 in 3,000. And then that was the rationale of starting a national newborn screening for congenital hypothyroidism using cord blood, and it has had significant impact with very, very good results. It started in the 1990s. However, with the advances in technology, tandem mass spectrometry was introduced in the field, and the lab in King Faisal Specialist Hospital had a major role in improving the technique, even internationally. And it was a very powerful technique that with a single blood specimen, you can screen for many conditions. And there was a pilot study with several hospitals participating with King Faisal, and the prevalence or the incidence was estimated to be 1 in 1,300, which is almost 4 to 7 times more common in comparison to other countries. And that was the rationale and the scientific basis of marketing, expanding the screening to do, instead of the cord blood, to do metabolic screening at the age of 1 to 3 days. So the National Newborn Screening Program for 16 conditions, 2 endocrine and 14 metabolic conditions, was approved, and that was the Royal Directive in 1424 to implement the program in different phases. So the first phase was officially launched under the patronage of King Salman bin Abdulaziz, and that was in August 2005. With the approval of screening for 16 conditions. And the first phase was to include 24 hospitals, major maternity and children hospitals across the country, and the lab operating the screening was King Faisal Specialist Hospital lab. However, in 1433, there was a directive from Ministry of Health to shift the operation to three regional labs in Ministry of Health in Riyadh, Jeddah, and Dammam. And at that time, the transfer of the operation included also expansion of including other hospitals. And in that period of time, there were 154 hospitals included. Currently, we screen for 17. VLCAD, which is one of the fatty acid oxidation disorders, was included recently. And all of these conditions, if not properly diagnosed and treated early, could cause death and disability. If we look at the recommendations of the American College of Medical Genetics that was published in 2006, because of the expansion of technology, we can screen for many, many metabolic conditions. And there has to be a way of screening whether condition A is something that we have to be, we have to include in the list, or a condition that in which management area does not make a huge difference. So there was a recommendation from the expert panel to include 29 conditions universally across the states. And these are the conditions, and if you look at our 17 conditions, all of them among these 29 conditions. What is the magnitude of the problem here? If we look at the data from our statistics in King Faisal, which is for about 800,000 babies since the beginning of the program. If we look at arginosuccinic aciduria, which is one of the urea cycle defects, we have an incidence that is at least 30 times more common in comparison to the states. And if you look at HMG, propionic, MSTD, citrullinemia, these are very common in comparison to other populations. And this is basically because of the presence of founder mutations that are distributed across the regions of the country. And we have geographic distributions that mirrors the tribal distribution of the country. We have pockets of methylmalonic acidemia in Mecca region, propionic acidemia in Riyadh, in Najran and Asir. Arginosuccinic aciduria, mainly in Riyadh, very high prevalence in certain tribes in that region. Citrullinemia in Medina and Al-Qatif. If we look at VLCAD, probably we have the highest incidence of VLCAD across the globe, and we have founder mutations that are highly prevalent in the northern part of the country. So we do have founder mutations that had made the prevalence of these conditions very high in comparison to other populations. If we look at the incidence of these 70 conditions, we have about 1 in 1,000. So it is estimated that we would have 1 to 2 new cases of preventable disability on each day. With the expansion of the population, more babies are born every day of the year. Newborn screening expansion with inclusion of other conditions, it is estimated that we will have 1 new case every 1 to 2 hours. And definitely, currently, we are not ready for this huge task. Where do we stand? If we look at the number of births, and this is just an estimation, it is almost 600,000 babies every year. Almost a third of these babies are born in Riyadh region, and this is across all the sectors of the health care system. But if we look at the Minister of Health private and governmental non-MOH hospitals, Minister of Health represents about 46%, private 42%, and the governmental university military hospital is about 12%. If we focus on the babies who are born in Ministry of Health hospitals, Riyadh represents the largest portion, 19%, followed by Al-Medina. And if we look at other regions like in Jeddah and Mecca, the percentage is less than this because private sectors represent a larger portion. This is a figure that shows if I provide newborn screening services to Ministry of Health hospitals, am I going to cover all the babies in these regions? If you look at Al-Jouf, Al-Grayat, Tabuk, Al-Hudud al-Shimaliya, if I provide services to Ministry of Health hospitals, then it will cover the entire newborn population. But if you look at Jeddah, Riyadh, Al-Sharqiyya, Mecca, the majority of the babies are born outside MOH. So even if I have full coverage in MOH, I'm going to miss a huge number of cases, which is unfortunately happening as we speak. If we look at the coverage of newborn screening, almost 173 hospitals are now offering newborn screening. We have very few hospitals that are left over, and most of these hospitals are very small. So 95% of the hospitals that are having deliveries have the service. I'm not talking about coverage. I'm talking about the service that is available. If we have the steps and the stages that had the newborn screening had gone through over the years, last year, the third phase of the program had been initiated with a training campaign started from Riyadh and in different regions of the country. If we look at the data from the regional labs, and we're talking about Ministry of Health hospitals, after screening almost 800,000 babies, there were 677 cases with an incidence of 1 in 1,100. And if we look at the cases over the past 3 years, we're approaching the figure of King Faisal, the other major operation of newborn screening in the country. The manual of the newborn screening had been revised recently, and it has been published and distributed across the screening centers with guidelines in relation to responsibilities of the newborn screening teams, regional newborn screening supervisors' rules, and guidelines in terms of screening for preterm, low birth weight babies, as well as those who had received blood transfusion and who are on TPN, in addition to guidelines for notification, which is a major, which has been a major gap in providing a continuity of care. If we look at the treatment centers for metabolic conditions in the country, there are now 20 centers. All are governmental. And the green dots indicate the Ministry of Health, and the red dots indicate the non-Ministry of Health hospitals, but all are governmental. There are currently 35 practicing metabolic physicians, 21 metabolic dietitians, a huge shortage of staff, especially if we talk about the dietitians. And if we look at the tertiary services that are available in the country where dialysis, advanced treatment can be provided to these complicated cases, we have only these regions in Riyadh, Eastern Province, and in the Western Province. And like probably other subspecialties, there is a huge concentration of specialists in Riyadh region, whereas we have no metabolic physician whatsoever in the northern part of the country, very few in the south. So the system in which there is an immediate referral of these cases to larger centers should be very, very efficient. The key performance indicators had been introduced in 2015. There are 12 KPIs, and I will share with you the first KPI, which is the most important one, which is the percentage of coverage. And we had developed, through the advisory committee of the newborn screening, zones, green, yellow, and red zones. And this is the performance of the major 20 hospitals in the country. And I'm talking about the hospitals, not the regions. There are excellent hospitals, and the one that had ranked the first and was awarded last year was Medina Children's Hospital. This is the largest maternity and children's hospital in the country. And in spite of this, they have a huge and excellent operation with excellent performance. And as you can see, we have regions that had performed in the red zone. If you look at the lab services, this has been a reflection of the fragmentation of the healthcare system in the country. Instead of having a central unified operation, we have many labs, and it seems that the list is expanding. We have the three regional labs. If you look at the different sectors in the country, we have Ministry of Health, Military Hospitals, National Guard, King Fahd Medical City, Security Forces, University Hospitals, and private hospitals. If you look at Ministry of Health labs, they offer screening for Ministry of Health hospitals, as well as Security Forces in Dammam and University Hospital in Riyadh. King Faisal, to military hospitals, university, and to private sectors. If you look at the National Guard, to National Guard. King Fahd Medical City, to King Fahd Medical City, as well as to the private hospitals. And we have a new private lab that had been offering screening for the private sector. It is very scattered, very fragmented operation. And if we look at the percentage, almost two-thirds done by Minister of Health Labs, one-third by King Faisal, National Guard, King Fahd Medical City, and the private lab represent only a minority of the babies that are screened in these labs. So the major problem is that what we are having now is in the private sector. We have an estimation of about 600,000 babies every year. If we look at the numbers of babies that are screened currently in the country by the major labs, we have about 300,000 babies that are screened for. So we are in the red zone. If we look at the entire nation, the percentage is about 50 to 60%. So we are, until now, missing congenital hypothyroidism, in which the treatment cost 41 riyals per year. And we are still missing phenylketonuria cases in this country. And it seems that over the years, we've looked at the problem as a lab rather than a program, a continuity of care that has to be lifelong. And instead of having only a program that looks at screening, follow-up, diagnosis, treatment, continuous evaluation, and continuous education, we've concentrated on the operation of the lab and forgot about the whole picture that has to be there. And what we are missing over the years is that we don't have an integrated system that is comprehensive with harmony, efficiency, authority, and centralization. The fragmentation is no good for newborn screening. The excellent examples in the whole world is when you have a central operation that would be like a national reference with expertise. Expansion, the screening for congenital heart disease and deafness had been ongoing and expanding with remarkable results. There is a huge pressure from the metabolic community to include other conditions that had not been included yet. There are ongoing pilot studies for cystic fibrosis and immune deficiency. And there is a huge pressure from the hematology community to include sickle cell disease. But what is next? What is the national priority? Is it to screen for congenital hypothyroidism, PKU, with a coverage that covers the entire nation? Or we screen the other region for 60 conditions or 50 or whatever, and we miss the other regions of the country? Where is the national priority? Who decides about this priority? Is it a priority that we have a horizontal expansion where we cover all the babies and then build up? Or we have vertical expansions with increasing of conditions and missing the other regions? Do we have a very strong infrastructure for newborn screening program? Which I'm afraid we don't. And it is very obvious to the professional community that we have very poor awareness among the public and unfortunately among the professional organizations and societies that we have a newborn screening program that has to be supported. These are the conditions. So we need to work on this. We're very glad that we had, for the first time in the country, the first public awareness day that was conducted in 2015 and in December 2016, and that had impact on the awareness. You're all invited to join the annual symposium for the newborn screening. This is the second annual symposium, which will be, inshallah, in May this year. Lastly, I will just go over a few steps that I think are mandatory so we can have the program successful. The first one is there is a need for higher management support. And this has been a bottleneck. And there has been a directive from the Saudi Council to mandate newborn screening across the country, but this has not been, unfortunately, implemented. The role of the National Health Lab is awaited for newborn screening. We're waiting for tracking those cases through the electronic birth registry system. And the KPIs had to be implemented by the regional health affairs. And the insurance package should also include the newborn screening implemented rather than just as a policy. And we need to foster the collaboration between the different labs. We cannot work in isolation with each other. This is a national project that everyone has to work on. Lastly, we are very much awaiting the new model of care that will be announced soon by the minister, and hopefully newborn screening will have a huge step forward with implementation of this program. Thank you very much.